Step into your power. We are very pleased to be with all of you on planet Earth to witness the expansion of your consciousness as it continues to unfold there on Earth. You have been granted access to your fifth density chakras in ways that you have previously been unable to access, and the results have been that many of you are experiencing new insights, recollections of past lives, including those that are off-world. And more of you are stepping forward to do the work that is necessary to clear the main seven third density chakras so that the fifth density ones can reign supreme. Your fifth density chakra system will grant you greater access to the multidimensional world. This universe contains many densities, realities, and so much more than you have tapped into previously. To tune into your fifth density chakras is by allowing this to happen, and that is all you need to do. That means whatever is or is not coming into your life, embrace it all, as it is necessary to do that extra work and clearing that grants you more access to the fifth density chakras. Whatever is coming into your life is just a way for you to do that extra work and clearing that is necessary to grant yourselves more access to what the fifth density chakras hold for you. Everyone will find that it is easier to connect to the higher realms, if that is what they desire. More and more people will discover they had gifts they did not know they had, and they will feel much closer to the time of full and open contact with ETs. You are stepping into your power now as sovereign beings because the days of assuming that someone or something outside of you was controlling everything are over. You are no longer playing that game and are ready to acknowledge that you are the creators of your reality 100% of the time. You are ready to step into your full power and your full potential and to come together with the galactic forces and the forces that are from the non-physical densities in this universe. That has been a requirement for all of you in this lifetime. First, you needed to deal with all the physical aspects of living there on Earth. That is why we say that as you face what you need to face, you allow yourselves to benefit even more from the energies that have granted you more access to your fifth density chakra system. Let it all in. Recognize that it is always coming and take time out throughout your day to close your eyes and take a few deep breaths and acknowledge that these fifth density chakras are present in your energy field, that they are ready to be of service to you. We are very interested in humanity's ascension because you are helping us to have experiences that we could not otherwise have without you. We want you to realize that you are in fact dreaming this reality into existence. And we invite you to consider what a monumental feat that is. You are masters, as only masters would take on such challenges. And we recognize this and love you for it. We also see you as the ones who create the most opportunities for expansion in this universe. And that is so exciting because everything you experience there is causing the universe to offer more opportunities to all beings within it. And you will experience everything that you have created at some point in the future. Our goal is to assist you in your creation of it sooner than later. And we want you to relax into the expansion of your consciousness and for you to enjoy your creations. These creations of yours coexist with you right now, and when you have faith that you will receive them, then you can continue your lives as normal. Then you can live your lives without anxiety regarding whether these manifestations will reach you or not. You are choosing every moment of every day. It is your creation. It is up to you what type of life you lead. Therefore, as fourth density beings, you are the ones determining what you experience next. By how you feel, how you vibrate, what you focus on, and what you believe in. We cannot emphasize enough that you must believe in yourselves and to accept the assistance that is coming from the higher realms. Because we enjoy helping, and not because you are unable to do it on your own. Receiving help is a manifestation after all. It is a creation of yours. It is a collaboration, an opportunity for us to connect with you, and an opportunity for you to connect with us and many other beings in the higher realms. It brings us closer as a universal family, and bringing us all closer brings the entire universe closer to Source, as we truly are all one being, pretending that we are not, making it all up as we go for the purpose of experience. We remind you consistently that this is a free will universe, and you get to decide what you experience and what you do not. We hold the knowing that we are infinite and eternal beings within us always. While you may think about it from time to time, it is not a part of your moment-by-moment awareness as it is for us. Connecting with us directly or through these messages, you are getting that gentle reminder. Again, we invite you to pay attention to how you feel when you absorb any content or any information. If it gives you that expansive feeling, then you know that it serves you. However, if it causes you to contract or feel fear, then it does not serve you. You have no need to judge anything that causes a deep, visceral response within you. All that is required is that you walk away from it, realizing that it is just not for you. When you have full recognition of self and feel infinite and eternal, that is when you will realize that you are everything that you seek, everything that you see and everything that you create, and you will not feel worried or fearful of anything at all. Those are the moments to build upon so that you are in that state of being more consistently. That is how to create the reality you want to experience. It is to realize that the reality is within you. Nothing is outside of you, and therefore nothing is inaccessible to you. When manifesting, you also want to pay attention to how you feel, because how you feel is your indicator to whether you are moving towards it or away from it. You can pay attention to that feeling when you are speaking words, thinking thoughts, and taking actions, and noticing whether you are expanding or contracting while doing so will always be helpful. Because ultimately you want that feeling of expansiveness, which is as close to being completely your infinite and eternal self for now. Taking the slow and steady approach to your ascension, you get to feel the expansion by having all these experiences one by one. You get to remember who and what you really are time and time again, because you keep forgetting. And please do not think that forgetting is a bad thing or a mistake. It was on purpose for each of you to engage in forgetting, for you all knew that the experience of remembering would be much sweeter. You cause us to expand when you ask for our assistance. You help us to become more of who we really are in the process of helping you. And we know that you are all there to be of service to humankind, whether you know it or not. And those of you who do know it, you are being of service whether you acknowledge it or not. By opening up and receiving more, you can become more of who you really are by helping others. It is how you expand, it is how you evolve spiritually and as a consciousness. You are there to go beyond the usual human experience, the usual human lifetime. You are there to expand into and become your higher selves, and the best way to do that is to look for someone or some group to help. It does not have to be a human or a group of humans. You can be helping an animal or a group of animals, a tree or a forest, a patch of land or the entire planet. There are many ways for you to experience that expansion that is available to you in every moment. However, the easiest way is to make yourself available to those in need. This is a time where there is much suffering happening there on Earth. And instead of complaining about what the governments are doing or not doing, you can reach out to someone in need and help them. And in doing so, you get to become more of your true self. And even though for you it might mean taking time and attention away from something else, we guarantee that it will be rewarding, and you will feel a sense of satisfaction and fulfillment. By doing this, you will be taking one step closer to becoming your higher self, which is who you will be as a fifth density being. We want to remind you that you are Source. Source is not a being that exists outside of you. Source is inside of you, and so is everything else. We know how hard it is for many of you to have acceptance of the truth that even a person or a belief that you despise exists inside of you and is not separate from you. What that means is that humanity needs humility in order to get to the next step in the evolution of your consciousness. You cannot place yourself high on a pedestal looking down upon everyone else. Do not fall into the trap of thinking that you have it all figured out, that you are doing everything correctly, and that you have all the right beliefs and information. That would be boring, thwart your growth, and be a type of death experience that does not really exist. You never stop growing. You never stop expanding. And you never stop becoming more of who you really are. In order to do all those things, you needed the end of the spectrum to exist that was furthest from Source, furthest from the light and the love that is your true nature. What is more Source-like than being able to love the darkness and those operating in the dark? If you truly understand what the shift in consciousness is, then you know that it is not just about a solar flash and 3 days of darkness. If you really know what the shift is about, then you know the real event is you becoming more like Source energy. And that means acknowledging that it is all inside of you, even the ones you want to condemn, even the beliefs that you cannot understand how anyone could even entertain. Once again, you have our respect and admiration. Because as we describe to you what you are being asked to do, we realize what a huge mountain that is to climb, especially when one of those beings that represents true darkness has done something to you or someone you love. Most of you had some terrible experiences in past lives and in this lifetime, traumas you are meant to clear. That too is not an enviable task to have signed up for. And once again, it is hard for us to even fathom making that choice. However, you did. And we know you did because you are there. If you are there, then you also get to have the biggest ride possible. You get to be there on the shift into the light, carrying you and the rest of humanity with it to where you all belong, becoming your higher selves. We love to hear from all of you directly. And when you speak those requests out loud, the energy that you infuse into the requests is felt not only by us, but by all others who are your helpers. The universe responds well to sound, and when you speak something out loud, you create a sound. You literally put something out into the universe that will go on and on. Now, as you connect to us with your requests, notice whether you can feel our energy. Our presence. Because if you can, then you know you have raised your vibration to the point, to the frequency, where that is a possibility for you. Being at a lower vibrational state and putting out a request to us, to your guides and to the universe, is not as effective as when you raise your vibration first and then state your desire out loud. As you move forward as individuals, you will notice that it is important to you that others receive what they desire as well. And when you have that desire for others, you align with all the helpers that exist throughout the universe, because that is their goal as well. The goal of any helper is to help as many people as possible. And because you are a part of a collective, anything that you desire for the collective you desire for you as well. You're a part of the collective of humanity. It is also important for you to recognize that you can always help others to raise their vibration. You do so by setting an example, by putting out a positive and high vibration. You do so by caring about how other people feel. When you listen with a compassionate ear, you have the tendency to elevate the vibration of the person you are listening to, because that is what they need in that moment. When you live your life from a higher vibrational state, you also attract others to you who are right below where you are vibrationally and will benefit the most from being around you or from hearing what you have to say. This is a beautiful time for you all to see yourselves as the leaders of humanity, as the ones who have the tools and the knowledge to get into those higher vibrational states. And again, when you do, you align with us. And you align with so many others throughout the universe who are of a higher vibration and want to help all of humankind. This ascension is not about separation or elimination. It is about integration and collaboration. The more you come together with your fellow humans, setting positive intentions for all, the easier the process of ascension will be for everyone. You are not doing this alone. Everyone who is there with you is a helper as well. Even though they are pushing your buttons, they are still helping you. Sometimes you need to be aware that you have pushable buttons, so you can do something about them. You want to be love in all situations when you are around all people, not just the ones that are easy to love. That too will keep you in a higher vibrational state. You will be the example you want to be to others. And you will be the leader that you know you really are in this movement of the ascension of the human collective consciousness vibration. That overall vibration continues to rise, and all of you who are a part of the awakened collective are a huge part of that. And when that is your goal, you have so much help coming to you from all directions. We are very particular about what we put our attention on. Because we know that if we put our attention on something, it will not be long before we are vibrating in harmony with it, and then creating more of it in our experience. All realities are real, and all truths are true. You are all choosing which reality you are experiencing right now, and in doing so, you are choosing which reality you are moving towards next. People keep arguing over what is true at this time, but those people think that there is just one reality that everyone is supposed to agree upon as the one true reality. Now, it is true that you can focus on a reality that you are not currently experiencing. But if that is the case, then that reality had better be the one you want to experience, because if you are putting your attention on it, then it is coming. Therefore, it is important to ask yourself whether you want to experience the reality that you are focusing upon, but is not right in front of you in the moment. You can even create realities for yourselves that are in the past from your current moment's perspective. We say that you choose wisely what you focus upon, because you do want to experience a good feeling reality, a reality where you get to experience what you want to experience. And you cannot do that while at the same time you are pushing against a reality that you read about on the internet. It is very, very important for you all to learn how to discern, and you do that by listening to your bodies, your emotions, your hearts, and your chakras. They will tell you whether the reality you are focusing upon is the one that you want to experience. However, you must listen to those signs that are coming to you from within your own beingness. We know that many of you receiving this message are aware of all of this. We also know that it is easier to hold this as a belief than it is to put into practice. Just as it is easier for you to say that you are source energy than it is for you to be source energy in action there in a physical body on Earth. These are a few of the challenges you have placed in front of yourselves for this very important lifetime. What we want you to do more is to pay attention to what you are focusing upon and how it feels, and we encourage you to ask yourself if that is a reality you truly want to experience. And if you want to go even further, then ask yourself why. Do you want to be right, or do you want to feel in alignment with Source? The choice is yours, and from our perspective, the choice is simple. We always choose alignment with Source, and we always feel the expansion of Source as a result. Trust us when we say that it is the only way to live, the only way to be, the only way to exercise your free will in this free will universe, with all its duality and polarity. Te wāna, tāua, te awa. Thank you.